Okay, let's start the session. So today we'll be talking about the ACI programmability. Before I start, right, let me introduce myself. I'm Krishna. I'm a part of Advanced Services. Right. So today we'll be talking more about what is ACI programmability, what are the different options available, and some of the use cases which you commonly see within the data center. Right. And also I'm going to show some demo and some provide some inputs. Like last time when we presented, people asked, like, can you provide us some samples so we can later reuse that. So I'm going to show the details about that. Okay. So this is the agenda, right? So we will talk about introduction to ACI programmability, what is REST APIs, what is Cobra SDK, and ACI toolkit, and then about what are the different use cases which you can commonly. So there are n number of use cases which you can automate, but we are going to predefine like 3 to 4 use cases which are more for the day one as well as day two, right? So which is more common for operations as well. And then we will see about the demo, which will talk about how these use cases are working, and simply how to start a simple program to start writing the code, right? So how many people are already familiar with Python or doing any programmability? Oh, perfect. So we have a good number of people. Okay. So let me start with how the engineers are doing the coding today, right? So it's more about box-centric deployment. So people are going to individual boxes or maybe SSH way of doing things. So you go and write automation with respect to SSH or device configurations, and then everything is done manually. Right? So it's mainly about copy-paste things. So you take a notepad, you copy the scripts, so it doesn't work sometimes. It works pretty well. But it's not going to scale in a longer run, right? As we are moving towards the software-defined networking, so everything, and also it's all the products are getting supported with REST APIs, right? So it can be too expensive as well, right? So what is the centralized approach? Because when we are moving towards the fabric, everything is going to be centralized, right? And then it's a single point of controller. So you are going to manage your data centers with single controllers with SDN architectures. Right? So you need to get familiarized towards the programmable configuration. Either it can be a network programmability or you're programming the controllers itself. So what are the different mechanisms you have? The main common thing which you can automate things are through REST APIs, right? So, and again, to make it simplified in ACI, we have different kind of, as I said initially, we have different kind of options. One is you can directly use the REST, or if to simplify the REST, we have something called Cobra SDKs, which is like a Python bindings, where you can use the functions and you can write the code, right? And the other, to even simplify better, we have something called ACI Toolkit. So how many are familiar with ACI Toolkit and Cobra SDK? Okay. So let's go to the programmability, right? So it has a the ACI full native REST support, because everything we do in ACI is the REST API. Whether you do with command line, or you do with the GUI, or directly you can use the REST, right? So there are a number of toolkits. So if you see, we are going to see that. So there are different toolkits and SDKs to build your code, right? But the biggest challenge is like, what are the different toolkits? How do I use it, right? Which is a simple way to automate? Because a lot of people coming from a networking background, right? So they started with the Python coding and other things. It's pretty, people want, oh, I don't want to learn too much of programmability, but I need to know how to start somewhere, right? So let's see about how to build a simple application from in ACI, right? So once we see the demo, we will show you like how to capture the XML, how to build the Python, and so on and so forth. Okay? So what is an architecture, right? So we have a fabric. So everyone is familiar with this. So we have a spine and leaf architecture. Then we have, how do you manage the fabric? So we have something called EPIC, which is a controller. So you're going to manage the entire fabric through EPIC, right? So but if I want to automate, if I want to configure something on the EPIC, right, what is the mechanism for me to do that? Which is like a REST API. So everything I want to touch the fabric, I want to talk to the controller is through the REST APIs. So if I want to simplify that further, right? So what are the different SDKs and toolkits what we have today? One is you can build your own apps. I think you are familiar now with Epic App Center. So which is like you can build your own apps which interact with REST APIs and do the apps. So it can, it's not restricting you to write a script, so you can run that app on the Epic itself, right? Which is like a business apps. And the second option is the ACI toolkit. So ACI toolkit is very like similar to your configuration objects, which is managed object in Epic, which is like a tenant, EPG. So you don't need to worry too much about the backend code, right? In the rest, if you want to go and write the code, you need to know what is a class, which class I need to call, what kind of parameters I need to pass to it, right? But tenant, it's very easy name for me. I want to go and create a tenant. So go to ACI toolkit. The objects are mapped exactly towards your naming conventions on the Epic, right? Which is very simplified. So we'll see more details about that. And the third one is Visuary. So how many people use Visuary? Good. So Visuary is basically like a object browser. So if you want to know, you are writing your code, I want to know what is object, what is the equivalent object for that, for a tenant, right? So it might be an FE tenant or a BD, FE BD. So I want to know what is the exact object. So I can go to Visuary and get more details about the object itself, right? And then we have fourth option called Cobra SDK. Why we have developed Cobra SDK? So you can still write with REST. To simplify commonly used functions, so the Cobra SDK will help you to wrap that functions, right? For example, if I want to log in, so it'll go just allow you to log in call, so you can go and log into the Epic. Otherwise, I need to go log in, get the token, parse it. So you need to do a lot more action. To simplify your programmability, so we have created called Cobra SDK, which is purely on the Python. And then you have GUI, which is familiar with Epic. And then you can use the orchestrators. So how many of you use the orchestrators for ACI automation? Anybody uses UCSD or Cloud Center or any other kind of automation? No. OK. So you can, again, you can use different, because they have their own workflows, so which will call the REST APIs on the back end, right? So whatever the mechanism you use, the finally it calls the REST. Right. So how do I build my program? Right. For the REST, you need to have a unique URL or URI. Right. So URI is basically what is the object I'm going to touch, whether it's a configuration. Because in the REST world, everything is a managed object. So we will see the hierarchy. What is a managed object? What is a management information tree? How do I know that? Because a lot of times in the automation world, it's easy to write the code, but very tough to troubleshoot. Right. You need to understand what is that object. Right. So we'll see about what is the managed information tree all about. And again, mapping to your business processes, right? So all your automation mapped to your business apps, whether it can be like app for monitoring, app you can build your own app for troubleshooting. So you can map everything, what are the mechanism you are using for programmability for your business processes. OK, so we have seen what are the different options available. So for the one option is I directly use the REST. So it can be used with any programming language, no bindings. Like you can use Java, you can use C, you can use Python. So anything underlying you want to wrap the REST, you can do that. So it is pretty straightforward and industry standard, right? And the second option is the Cobra SDK. So I want to simplify further. I want to write in Python, but there is no other bindings today directly SDK is delivered. But if you still want to use it, you can use it with Python, only Python SDK, right? And then the third option is ACI toolkit, so which is even simplified version of it. So it maps exactly with your management objects. So we will see about the management objects in a minute. And finally, the orchestrator. So we have already inbuilt supported orchestrator like UCS Director or Cloud Center or any third-party orchestrator which calls the REST in the backend, right? OK, so we talked about the management objects. What is this management object? What is this management tree, right? So in the REST world, you need to understand what is a management object. So every object you create in ACI is related as a management object. For example, like a tenant is a management object. A BD is a management object. Or an application profile is a management object, right? All these management objects are hierarchy into a tree, which is called management information tree. So if you want to create, because every object has a parent-child relation, so if you want to create a BD, BD should be part of what? A tenant, right? An application profile should be part of a tenant. A tenant should be part of maybe a VRF, something like that. So there are some interbindings. There might be crosslinks, but everything follows a bigger tree structure. That is called ACI tree, which is a management information tree, right? So all the configuration elements, when you're going to use the REST, so you're going to call a managed object to really configure or to update or to delete, right? So what are the REST calls? So most of you are familiar with the REST, right? Either it's a POST or a GET. So if you want to get information, it's on the managed object. If you want to post the information, it's on the managed object. Right? So you need to familiar with what are the managed objects. So I want, what do I want to query? At what hierarchy level? Right? So all the network configuration is present in the form of a management information tree. Right? So you can directly query the child, you can directly query the middle of node, or you can directly query the entire parent tree. So why is important? When you're going to do the REST queries, you need to understand whether I want an individual object or the child objects of that. For example, if you query for a tenant, you only get the information about tenant. But if you want to query the entire child objects of tenant, so you'll get the entire configuration of tenant. Right? I'll get the tenant, I will get all the application profiles, all the BDs, all the VRFs, and also all L2, layer 3, layer 2 outs, service information. These are all the child objects of tenant. Right? So you need to figure out, like, what do I want in the automation? Just a tenant creation or the child objects creation as well? Right. So again, it's all about creating the tree. So you create a new objects, you modify existing objects, or you delete the objects. These are the three things you do, mostly in the automation. Right? I want to go and create day one of task, I want to monitor something, or update something, an object, or I want to go and delete the objects. The API provides the full access to this tree. So the REST API, which the ACI provides, it will provide the entire management tree is fully exposed. So there is no hidden things. So whatever you can do it on the GUI, you can do with the REST APIs. Okay. So the next question is, like, how do I build this REST call? What is a URI? Right. So let's go through that. Okay. So let's jump into the REST. Right. So what is the REST API? So the REST is the only interface you want to interact with Epic. Right? Whether you use a toolkit, whether you use the Cobra SDK, or you use Orchestrator, you use the app, everything in the backend should call the REST call. Right? So these are some of the mechanisms today, what has been used for accessing. Whether you use the GUI, in the backend it will call you the REST. So we will see in the demo how the GUI, how do you capture the REST call. You can easily capture the REST call and automate it. Overall, your code, right? And then the CLI. If you want to use the CLI, how do the backend it will call the REST and rest of other mechanisms, right? So then within the REST, everything in the REST is built through a distinguished name. What is this a distinguished name? So if I want to browse the object in the tree, there should be a unique name, right? So if I want to go and access an application profile, I need to know what is an application profile. So application profile will be part of which tenant. So it will be part of which fabric itself. Right? If you have multiple fabric deployed, so you need to know the entire structure. So that is a distinguished name. Distinguished name is a global unique name within your fabric. Right? So if you see here, everything in the programmability will start from top root. Because it's a structure, whether it's a XML or a JSON, so it will be having a structure. Right? So your structure will start from a root. Then I have a universal object. So then I have a tenant object. Within the tenant, I have application profile. Then I have an EPG. So if I want to query the EPG, I need my DN should look like slash uni, slash tenant, AP, and EPG. This is how you built your URI. Because in the REST, you need to tell them like what object I'm interested in, what object I need to modify. Right? So some of the examples here, but we'll see more details into the program. Okay. The next option is the Cobra SDK. What's the difference? So we have seen the REST, right? So Cobra is basically the SDK which is wrapped on top of REST. So especially to simplify, right? So it is a native Python binding. So it's a Python SDK. So you can simply call the direct calls. So you don't need to parse too much the information, what you do in the REST, and then pass it back. So the internally, the functions are implemented in such a way, so it will do all the actions for you to simplify your programmability, basically, right? So every Cobra SDK object has a one-to-one mapping with the REST call in the backend. So if you have a tenant, there will be a Cobra equivalent object for it. If you want EPG, there will be a equivalent Cobra object for it. Right? So this is how you create your configuration. So in this, say if you see, I'm going to look for the universal object. Right? So what I'm going to do, I'm going to create a tenant called tenant Cobra. First, I'll bring where do I create in the structure of managed object? The initial object is uni, then you have a tenant, then you have application profile, APG. So that's how you need to first get into uni, then you go to the tenant. Right? once you have that created, which object you need to create, it's simple, right? So you go and create a config request object, and then you add that into a topology, into the main configuration, and commit. That means once you do a commit, it'll go and create actually pushing the configuration onto the Epic through the REST call. So if I want to do similar things in the REST, my code looks like almost like another 40 lines of code. Right? With the Cobra, it's more simplified. You can directly call 3 or 4 calls, so which will do the backend all the processing for you. Right? So even to further simplify, right? So if I want to do this, oh, I need to understand what is this Cobra MIT request. So what are the packages available? I need to import those packages. I don't want to remember naming conventions. So I want to even simplify it even further, right? So let's see what is the different mechanism to simplify it. So we have something called ACI toolkit, which is even further simplified version of your REST API calling, right? Which is like, okay, I have everything like a basic components like tenant, EPGs, and contracts, because everyone understands that. When you're touching the ACI, I understand these basic objects, which is tenant EPGs. So I don't need to know like complex names in the classes like cobra.mit.request or something else, right? Okay, so the SDK, we will see how ACI toolkit simplifies. So it's all about calling a tenant, EPGs, and other things, right? So we have seen the different mechanisms. Let's jump into the use cases, right? What are the common use cases? Why do we need automation? What are the different automatic use cases, right? So what kind of things I can automate? Where do I start with, right? Okay, so the first, we recommend strongly start with an easy task. First is like, okay, log in to an object, to an ACI, create some kind of a tenant, and then slowly you can do the day-to-day task like monitoring your fabric, then upgrading your fabric or changing the object, deleting the object. So you can do multiple things. Whatever you want to do, you can automate everything. Or bring up your own fabric, entire fabric itself through automation, right? So how much time it will take for you to do manually? If I want to create like I want to build like a 10 fabrics, how much time it will take for you today? A quite amount of time, right? Because I need to go build a fabric and then create the objects. I need to assign the objects, so on and so forth, right? So with automation, you can bring it up with a fraction of minutes. That's a powerful power of automation. And the second thing, not only just configuring the things, right? I want to get a notifications. I have my own centralized monitoring station, right? If something goes down, I want to get notified, right? So I want to get all the events to be into a single pane of glass. How do I do that? So you can automate the tasks, right? So we will see a couple of different, starting from easy to difficult. And also, you can also build some kind of apps, like visualization apps. So what are the tenants? What are the EPGs? Or maybe I want to know what are the endpoints, how my data center is structured together already with ACI. So we can build some visualization graphs with ACI toolkit. Okay. So the first use case is a deployment use case, which is common for most of the people, right? They want to make the deployment simpler, easier, and faster. Okay. So in the deployment use case, so first is like a deploy a new application, right? And then turn that requirements into the configuration. Basically, I want to deploy 10 tenants, new application, new tenant, or new application profile, or EPGs, I need to go and create manually, right? Which I can automate, because I just need a script to deployment automation, right? Then you create EPGs, BDs, and tenants, configurations, et cetera, right? What is the main goal? So main is like to bring up new applications. How fast you can provision? What is the time you take today to provision application? In a legacy way, right? Don't think about the automation, right? How much time it will take? It will take a couple of hours, right? Because I need to manually create the configurations. I need to click, make sure that I don't forget the things before I do it, right? So if I have written the script or a Python script or maybe a ACI toolkit, it will be like just a click, right? Okay, the second use case is the monitoring, right? So anybody uses any monitoring solutions today to monitor the fabric? Users? Basic things, okay. Yeah, so I'm going to show you, it's a small, simple script. You can monitor entire config changes. If I create an object, delete an object, if I update something, I can trigger the event, right? Either one way is to subscribe. It's a simple thing, right? Subscribe to the events, right? It'll automatically fetch you all the information, whether it's your own portal or your own other tools, if you want to centralize. So this is what about the monitoring the fabric use case, right? So this is what all about. Let me know what something changes within the fabric. Then something change, the object needs to be notified. Very simple, right? So it's easy for you to develop yourself. Right? So let's jump into the next one, right? So you can go to the third one, right? Is a troubleshooting. A lot of time people say, oh, my interface is down, something is not working, the traffic is not flowing, so I want to know some troubleshooting use case. This is very common for the day two, right? So this is one of the use cases. You can simply write the script to see how many interfaces are up. What is the state of an interface? Whether it's up or not. It's like some kind of a health check, right? Which is very commonly used within the data center. So let then move to the other use case, which is very powerful. So which is like today with ACI fabric, sometimes people say, hey, it's too complex because I can't go and search for endpoint, right? If I can write a script, just search for an endpoint or an EPG or a tenant, so it becomes more simpler for me, right? So this is more commonly used use case, right? So and now it is built into the fabric itself, the functionality, right? So let me quickly move on to the next one. The fourth one is a visualization. So this is very powerful with ACI Toolkit. You can visualize most of your things because ACI Toolkit provides, okay, I want to know the overall my object structure, how the tenants have been laid out. There's a cable diagram. I want to verify the cable management. I want to verify overall the usage of the fabric, the capacity planning, how much of the, so you can do multiple things with the visualizations. So which is a very powerful with ACI Toolkit. You just need to do a couple of lines of code, which will give you the visualizations. Either you can integrate with your portals, or you can keep it as a standalone apps. So the app store is even powerful. So you can build your own apps, and you can run it on the Epic itself. Right? So one of the examples is the endpoint tracker app, the visualization. So it's so complex. I want to know how the endpoints are distributed within the fabric, whether it's a single pod or a multi-pod. So if you have multi-pod, that even it becomes more complex, whether it's coming from data center 1 or data center 2. So I want to visualize how the endpoints are tracked within the data center, right? So how this is how you can track with respect to the endpoint tracker. So the ACI toolkits will provide you the information. So this is my node, leaf 1. So what are the endpoints connected to leaf 1? So what are the endpoints connected to leaf 2? So I can easily see if the endpoints are moving around, you can at any point of time, you can go and say, hey, this endpoint is pointing to leaf 3 now, not on the leaf 1. There might be some change in the network, right? So this way, you can visualize, you can integrate this with your own tools or own portals. App? Apps. OK, good question, right? So the question is about what version on the ACI need to be there, right? So whatever I'm showing, this is from the day one. So if you want REST APIs, ACI Toolkit, you can be on the any version from 1.0. But if you want to be on the App Store, you need to be 2.2, which is coming up, right? So you need to upgrade your code to 2.2, where you have an app tab, so you can build your own apps. But if you don't want the apps within in the Epic, if you want to build your own apps, it can be through ACI Toolkit. You don't need, you know, it can be any version. And the final use case is, OK, now I have deployed. How do I verify it? Whether my configs are correct, or am I doing some best practices? Because a lot of times people say that, OK, I have left a lot of objects in a stale way. How do I ensure that my deployment verification? So you can write a simple script saying that, OK, all the layer 3 outs are properly configured, the OSPF sessions are up, or my BGP sessions are up. So you can verify your entire configuration. You can write a script to validate. If the validation, OK, move to the production. If not, you need to fix it, right? So there are a couple of scripts you can write and you can validate it, right? So these are some of the use cases, right? So let's conclude this, and I'm going to walk through the demo, right? So ACI has very open API. It's nothing closed. Whatever the operations you want to do, you can do it with API. Whether you can do with REST, whether you can do with Cobra, whether you can do with ACI Toolkit, everything is very open. In the back end, it calls the REST API, okay? And then, so for doing this, you don't. A lot of people are saying like, "Hey, I'm a network engineer. How do I start with it?" Right? So let's start. Let me show you how simple to write a program. Right? We have built something called a tool, or you can say a tool or a script, which is called ARIA. How many are aware of ARIA? Yeah. So it is so simple and powerful. So it's like basically you are taking your XMLs from the ACI and converting into Python itself. It's a REST to Python adapter. So it will convert the code into Python. You just need to modify something, and your code is ready. So that's how simple it is, right? So I don't need to be a solid programmer, but I can start to automating the things. That's what all about the ACI program. So let me quickly jump in to the demo. OK. While it's logging in, let's see. OK, I have two tenants. I want to do a diff. I want to know what the configurations have been changed. Right, with the tenant one, what objects are existing, if I do some changes. This is mainly for some kind of an audit. Like if you want to do an audit in your ACI fabric, right? So it will show you everything. Sorry. So it will spit out everything in JSON format. So it will show you the differences. What you need to do is you just take this and feed it to ARIA, and it will convert into a Python program. Right? Or if you want to make, put this into a CMDB. So if you want to know, like, OK, these are the objects which have been changed from period to period. Maybe if you want to do an audit, OK, at this point of time X, these are the configuration. At this point of time, the configuration has been changed. So if you want to quickly do a diff. Right? So it's very simple and powerful. Let me show you. It's very simple lines of code which has been written. Right? So everything here is written through the ACI, through Cobra SDKs. So this is what it is, right? So it's going, getting the tenant information. So both tenants, it get the information and doing a comparison. A small Python kind of a code which do the diff, actual native, but fetching the information from the APIC is through the Cobra SDKs. Right? So I'm not going in deep down. So I'm going to provide you access. You can download the scripts. You can play around with this later. Okay. Okay, so this is one more powerful kind of a monitoring script, right? So it's waiting for the events. Basically, it's an event subscription. Not too complex. I just subscribe the events. Anything changing in the fabric, any changes I'm doing, it is getting notified. Right? So let me go to the Epic. Let's see what if I want to go and create something, right? So I'm going to create a tenant. So I create a tenant called demo. You can see the changes. The tenant, the demo was created. Right? So I just went and subscribed to entire the changes in the fabric. So it's very simple. I can get all the changes which is happening in the data center. I can monitor who is doing changes in the fabric. So this can be, again, like a monitoring tool. You can integrate with your existing tools, or you can keep it as a standalone app itself. Right? So again, there are a couple of other things which you can, let me show you if I can quickly show. Right? OK, there is one more script for creating the tenants. This is mainly to bring the use case of how do I do a day one configuration, creating a tenant, EPGs, BDs. So this script, what it does, it will go and create tenants. And then how many tenants? I'm giving a tenant name as five. Five tenants it will go and create. And then you can prefix with whatever the name of the tenant you want. Right? So if you quickly go and show into the Epic, you can see that there are no multiple tenants like that name. Right? So see, there is no tenant called tenant X. So if I quickly run, so I'm going to create five tenants. Oh, sorry. I'll go back. can see how fast it is. So it went and created all the tenants. Right. Similarly, you can write your own simple things. So now we have seen that the actions, right? How to write a simple thing, right? I want to know what is a URL, what is a REST, how do I download it, right? So there is a couple of inbuilt things which has been done in ACI. I think most of you are familiar with API Inspector, right? Sorry? Correct. Yeah, I created the child objects full. Yeah. Okay. So this is a simplified thing. So which is basically to capture your the XML, right? So the same thing what I have done. Maybe I'll create one more tenant, right? So if I want to create a tenant, how do I build a script? Let me go and add create a tenant called API test. Okay. So it created a tenant called API test. So now you can, so where did it go? Okay. So you can see here, maybe I can make it bigger. So this is what this, just the request called FE tenant. This is a URL which is calling for the REST API, and this is a payload. Basically, I'm going telling that go and create a tenant called API test. So you can capture this, and then you do a post, either using a Postman or a REST, any other REST editor, or you can convert that into a Python. Right? No, not it. I'll show that. Yeah. So this is the simplest way to get the REST API calls. So any action you do, you can directly go to the API Inspector, capture the URL and payload. That is what your call all about. So let me show you now, how do I convert this into a Python, right? So there is a utility, or we call it as a script, which has been published. Everything is on the GitHub, so you can go and download. It's called GitHub/datacenter, something called Aria. So you just need to download, it's a Python script, right? You download and install on your laptops. And then once you install, OK, now I need to go and create a tenant or any object. You go to the Epic. You can do one way of doing is you can capture that URL and the payload, or you can right click on the object itself and save the XML. Right? So in this case, let me show you how you are saving the XML, right? Okay. So save as. So only thing you need to remember when you're in doing this option is you want to have a self object or you want to have a subtree. So what's the main difference of this? Self is the same managed object, whereas a subtree is basically if you want to go deeper, like you want to know the BDs, application profile under tenant, right? Entire management subtree of the dependent child. So you need to select a subtree. If I want to just a code for XML for only the object itself, self is enough. So it's up to you which one you want to write, right? So in this case, I'm going to say a subtree, right? So then export format. What is this? So it's basically if you are more comfortable with XML or a JSON, so you can select whichever format, because it's both is supported. So once you download, so you can just copy that into a location called Aria, wherever it's a script. So in my case, I have just imported. So as I said, Aria is basically a script, right? So either you can do one thing. In Aria, let me show that. There are multiple options. If you want to convert a couple of files together, whole directory you want to convert into Python, you can do that. Or you just want to do individual file, converting from REST to Python, you can do that. So there are multiple options. So if you see here, either you want to save it as a file, or you want to save it old directory. I want to create all the objects together into Python, and then I'll go and modify it. You can do both the ways, right? So I'm going to show you whatever the tenant I downloaded, how do I convert it, right? So let me, I have created the two directories. One is input and output. Let me see what is there in the output, right? Let me remove all the files, what is there in the output, right? So let me go back to the input. See, these are the XMLs which I'm going to download it from the Epic, right? Right-click, save the object, and show it. Right. So now I want to convert this into a Python. There is no Python, right? So I want to convert into Python so that I can modify, add my logic, then I can push it to Epic. Right? So what you need to do is you can run the ARIA. Yeah. So I'm going to now do all the code I'm storing in input. I'm outputting everything to output. That means I'm converting all the XMLs, what I have downloaded, I want to convert into Pythons. Right? So you just need to do that. Sorry. I'm in the wrong directory. You can see here, right? So now it has converted all your XMLs, what are in the input directory, it will convert it into your Python scripts. So you can go to the Python, you can modify. So only cautious is we made an exception in ARIA. Don't run blindly the Python which has been created. It'll throw an exception. Because we want the people to review before they run it, right? Because it's auto-generated one. Right? So let me show you the test tenant. Oh, sorry. I was not in the wrong directory. Right. So it will show you what XML you have generated. Right. So it will show you the XML. This is what it auto-generated. And this is the exception I was talking. Right. So please remove it before you run it. So because it's auto-generated code. Right. So you have got your Python. So what you need to do is, this is for a tenant. I download a tenant. If you want to create a multiple tenant, you just need to write a loop in a Python logic. Right. Or you want to create multiple objects of endpoints, or you want to subscribe to some events. So you can download any XML, whatever you see on the Epic, you can convert into Python. Very simple, straightforward. Right. So but everything you can download through the GitHub site. Even the examples which I shared is already on the GitHub. Right. So this is on the datacenter, github.com/datacenter. You can go there. And if you are more looking for the entire REST APIs, so this is the configuration guide where you can get more detail about what are the different REST calls, what is supported, what kind of parameters I need to pass. It's very detailed, and there are some examples also. So if you click on this, you can say, OK, I want to manage layer 2 networking. Right? So what is the sample? How do it looks like? Right? So it shows you the entire sample. How do I need to do the query? Right? And similarly, we have for the ACI toolkit. If you go here, ACI toolkit, again, this is on the GitHub data center. You just need to go. The instructions are there, how to download the toolkit, what are the dependencies, and all documented. You can go there, and there are also samples here. So this is where you get the detail view on the samples. So go to the samples. You can download the samples, play around with that. And there is also applications. This is what I was talking about, the visualization apps. So if you go to the applications, so you have multiple applications pre-built. One is like the cable plan, the config push, endpoint tracker. So these are all some of the applications which are already available. If you feel I want to develop something new which I don't find it here, you can build your own apps. Right? So these are very powerful because a lot of times the ACI cable plan, people want to verify the connectivity pieces. So it will show you the entire cable diagram. So it will validate the endpoints, where it has been connected, whether the cables are connected, the interface are up or down. So you can get all the details from that. And then we have, again, the Cobra SDK is also on the GitHub. So you can go to /datacenter. You can see the entire Cobra bindings. Again, you have a samples. So go to the examples. You can go. It's a step-by-step detailed. You can write your simple scripts. And then if you want to do from basics, use a API inspector, what I showed. Use the API inspector, get your REST code or XML, and then convert using ARIA, start with that. This is how you can start building your own apps, right, our own scripts within your data center. You can automate everything, what you are doing manually today on ACI, you can automate everything. But different mechanisms available, use Cobra or ACI toolkit or Python, ARIA itself, so you can convert it. So, and then I think you have seen the DevNet page. So we have a lot more examples on the DevNet. If you go there, again, you have the overviews, building a simple script. There are a lot of videos around that. So you can play around that. So you can do a lot more programmability. Okay. So with this, I'm going to go back and see if there are any questions, and then. Okay, the question is about, do we have a sandbox to test it, whether what are the script I'm writing, how do I validate without pushing into production, right? So either there are multiple options. You can go to DevNet, there is a sandbox, or you can go to dcloud, there is a simulator version. So in the simulator version, you can create the epics, push your configs, test your automation scripts, then you can move to production. Correct, it's a simulator. Exactly. That's what it's all about, ACI simulator. You can download that. It's exactly, you can query exactly like your ACI. You are on the physical fabric. Okay. Any other questions? Okay. Maybe I think they'll release after the session.
Yeah.
Yeah. So please let us know if you have anything. So I hope you enjoyed the session. Please provide the feedback. Thank you.